A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me, son of man, prophesy against the shepherds of Israel, and these words prophesy to them. Thus says the Lord God, woe to the shepherds of Israel who have been pasturing themselves. Should not shepherds rather pasture sheep? You have fed off their milk, worn their wool, and slaughtered the fatlings, but the sheep you have not pastured. You did not strengthen the weak, nor heal the sick, nor bind up the injured. You did not bring back the strayed, nor seek the lost, but you lorded it over them harshly and brutally. So they were scattered for the lack of a shepherd, and became food for all the wild beasts. My sheep were scattered and wandered over all the mountains and high hills. My sheep were scattered over the whole earth, with no one to look after them or to search for them. Therefore, shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. As I live, says the Lord God, because my sheep have been given over to pillage, because my sheep have become food for every wild beast for lack of a shepherd, because my shepherds did not look after my sheep, but pastured themselves and did not pasture my sheep. Because of this, shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God, I swear I am coming against these shepherds. I will claim my sheep from them and put a stop to their shepherding my sheep so that they may no longer pasture themselves. I will save my sheep that they may no longer be food for their mouths. For thus says the Lord God, I myself will look after and tend my sheep. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Only goodness and kindness will follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, he saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and he said to them, you too go into my vineyard, and I'll give you what is just. So they went off. And he went out again around noon and around 3 o'clock and did likewise. Going out about 5 o'clock, he found others standing round and said to them, why do you stand here idle all day? They answered, because no one has hired us. He said to them, "You too, go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So when the first came, they thought they would receive more. But each of them also got the usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones worked only 1 hour, and you've made them equal to us who bore the day's burden and the heat." He said to them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Am I not free to do with as I wish with my own money? Or are you envious because I am generous? Thus the last will be first, and the first will be last." The Gospel of the Lord. In the course of the Office of Readings in the Breviary, we have a series of excerpts. It's not what's going on right now in the Breviary, but we have a series of excerpts from St. Augustine's writings, which is a reflection on this passage from Ezekiel, only he is transferring it to leaders in the church, which makes a lot of sense. And you know, you can see how, in fact, we have had in the past and have in the present shepherds who really, really love to nourish themselves on the sheep, okay, and live certain lifestyles that are not exactly what you call gospel poverty. And we've seen one bishop in Germany basically defrocked as a result of it. We see scandal hitting with other bishops, some of them in this country, building quite palatial places for themselves to retire in. And they're getting a little more than a little warning, I think, from Pope Francis that this might not quite be appropriate. You mix that with the whole problem of shielding sex abuse of children, and it gets to be a mess. Toward the end of the apostolic exhortation, Evangelii Gaudium, Pope Francis talks about how it's terribly important if you want to be a valid evangelizer, a spirit-filled evangelizer. It's terribly important, he says, to make sure that you're not looking at yourself. He's talking to bishops and priests. You're not supposed to be grandees, that was his word, okay? Looking down on people, you're supposed to be right there in the midst with them. That's been the theme of most of his papacy, frankly. He wants a poor church for the poor. He wants people to be in the margins where people are needed. So it's a whole different kind of a mentality and outlook. You need to have shepherds, therefore, that actually care about the sheep. Ezekiel says, you know, and he's speaking from a political point of view, his metaphor is political right here. He says, these leaders, these government leaders, kings and princes and whatnot, are not doing what they're supposed to be doing. And so God will come. But we know that Jesus, in fact, takes this passage and refers to himself as the good shepherd. He's the one shepherd, and everybody else shepherds through him and with him. So we can give thanks to God for the presence of Jesus Christ, that shepherd. We can ask the Lord to help us to be open to his leadership and for all of us to be people who support one another in our poverty, in our wealth, whatever it happens to be, so that we can bring others closer to Jesus. Let us stand and pray.